Nairobi, November 2019. The Kenyan capital was celebrating the 25th anniversary of ICPD, the International Conference on Population in Development. Governments, international organizations, feminists and youth activists were there, determined to make clear commitments that will advance the ICPD goals and ensure the rights and dignity of all people. Thousands of young people from around the world mobilized to prepare for the event and, most importantly, to share their development goals. The members of the 23 African countries, the network of adolescents and youth in population and development in West and Central Africa, was present. This region of the continent, whose population is among the youngest in the world, met in the Senegalese capital for the first edition of the 25 Heures de Dakar with the main theme, the contribution of African youth to the Nairobi summit. And to do so, they benefited from the support of the United Nations Population Fund, UNFPA.
I think that Afrian is an organization of young Africans.
Afrian is a young African's organization whose objective is to contribute to building Africa by 2063. This organization exists in all the countries and its ambition is to be present in each city and each department, in each district and each house. You see why Afrian is a construction tool for the Africa we want by 2063, a new and prosperous Africa that is led by its children and that has a place in the international scale.
Une Afrique a une place au niveau de la scène internationale.
19 months later, in June 2021, African members met in the Senegalese capital for the second edition of the 25 Heures de Dakar.
Since we came from Nairobi, we've been motivated by the ICPD's commitment, and now we are ready to contribute in the awareness-raising process in our communities and train our fellows and families on the field. This is the type of train we have made so far, and I'm convinced that if the youth are supported, we have the means to change this world.
Les jeunes sont confrontés au problème d'emploi.
Youths are confronted with employment and entrepreneurship constraints and a lack of information regarding sexual and reproductive health. Adolescents are also confronted with education and good governance difficulties, but also to problems in relation with drug use among the youth. These types of problems are the most recurrent in some West and Central African countries.
Surtout de l'Afrique de l'Ouest et centrale.
En Afrique, les jeunes rencontrent quasiment les mêmes problèmes.
In Africa, the youth are confronted with almost the same problems, including employment and education. In Africa also, our population is very young, with over 60% of the population that is under 25. We think that our concerns must be addressed if we want to reach the Africa we want by 2063 and reach the sustainable goals with the Agenda 2030.
Youth are confronted with three types of problems, like unemployment, insecurity, and clandestine immigration. The latter is one of the main problems youth is facing in Africa. In West Africa, most of the youth are confronted with insecurity, terrorism, jihadism, and other types of extremist attacks. This is due to poverty that is gaining ground, added to unemployment.
These are problems that many young people in Africa are facing and that have already been the subject of evaluations and programs in vain. The network of adolescent and youth in population and development in West and Central Africa is called upon for solutions or new strategic approaches.
Eu acredito que uma das maiores realizações tem a ver com a expansão.
I think one of the greatest progress we have made is due to the extension of the organization. It is done in the continental scale and covers all the countries that are committed in the project. Recently, in 2017, there has been a planetary commitment, including high-level discussions like the rebranding Africa Forum and the advocacy section we carry out in New York. Our goal is to include youth in all strategic discussions, in the political level and also in civil society organizations, so that their voices will be heard. In so doing, they will be able to participate to the development process and so help reach the Sustainable Development Goals in 2030, as well as the African Agenda by
2063.
We have many models like advocacy, awareness raising, capacity reinforcement, and youth competence development. As we have a network of youth associations in each country, this consists of dealing with all these concepts in these leagues. Added to other interest topics like gender-based violence, youth and adolescents' sexual health. We also work on leaders' capacity reinforcement. For example, here in Cameroon, where I am the executive secretary, we have already been trained in several topics like these by insisting on results. That's why we organize capacity reinforcement for these leaders. We organize these trainings each year, which allows us to set up action plans and strategic ways to arrive at successful results. What we do is raising youth's awareness upon thematic themes, like I told you a while ago, like drug consuming within the youth. Now we go to remote areas, as we already covered urban areas and cities. In Cameroon, we cover regions, while in other countries, they speak about departments. We meet the youth and talk to them. We reinforce associations' capacities so that they can do the same for their own communities.
Concernant le développement de compétences, qu'est-ce que le jeune aimerait faire?
Pour Afrian, nous sommes dans trois axes.
At Afriam, we are in three domains that are awareness raising, capacity reinforcement, and advocacy. When we speak about capacity reinforcement, this is to allow youth to have enough knowledge to manage their own situation. This to allow their own preoccupations to be considered because, as you know, in 2017, the African head of states had defined as a roadmap on insisting on investments on youths. Some have already started deploying their roadmaps, while others haven't so far. In our meeting, we're trying every time to remind head of states about their own commitments. Afrian tries whenever possible to be in front line for that.
Accomplir la mission que nous avons.
Afrian apporte une solution aux jeunes africains.
Afrian brings solutions to African youth through education, entrepreneurship, good governance, and health for all, because without these, Africa cannot develop while the youth are Africa's future. We want to build Africa through these axes like entrepreneurship, this by valuing all the potential that exists in this rich continent. We have a young population, and Afrian has decided to invest on that youth by training, coaching and informing these youth in order to arrive at the type of Africa we want, in order to arrive at capturing the demographic dividend. In terms of achievements, as you know, Africa is a pioneer in Africa. We have invested a lot in terms of capacity reinforcement and project management. Apart from these, we have also much worked on sexual and reproductive health awareness raising, peace and governance, but also we made a lot of work on COVID-19 preparedness and prevention in Africa. As you know, we've been through the COVID-19 for almost 2 years now, which means that we made a lot of capacity reinforcement. In addition to that, there has also been a lot of resources mobilization to materialize our projects in each of these countries.
The African General Assembly marked the beginning of the second edition of the 25 Hours of Dakar. The young people chose first to consolidate the structure by evaluating the report of the outgoing team. This will be followed by the resignation of the Regional Executive Secretary.
Then the General Assembly will have to adopt revised text before designating the new members of the Regional Executive Secretariat of the Network of Adolescents and Youth in Population and Development in West and Central Africa. In addition, African members will learn about the main topics that will be discussed during the second edition of the 25 Hours of Dakar.
L'objectif de cette assemblée générale, c'est déjà de rencontrer l'ensemble.
The objective of this meeting is to arrive at gathering all our West and Central African Bureau members, but also to guarantee accountability. We've been working for 3 years now, so we needed to stop and analyze what worked and what did not. We also need to change our taxes and set up a new staff, because some of our members have now more than the required age and they have to allow other youth to integrate the board. These are also part of our assembly, and as you know, at AFRIEN, we must insist on accountability. That's why we needed to organize this assembly and account for our actions and initiatives. That's why we gathered all our members from West and Central Africa to decide on our future.
De l'Afrique de l'Ouest et du Centre pour en discuter et voir ensemble l'avenir.
E portanto, o principal objetivo é...
The objective of this General Assembly is to set up a new board that will be composed of new members, but also of some who were in the outgoing board. This to keep lessons and experiences learned and plan for new things. The new team will be also composed of some young members who will come and learn about what we've been doing, and then share that experience with the new generation that will arrive. The purpose is to keep AFRIEN's momentum high up, as the organization has been existing since 2005. As you know, a lot of young leagues disappear when its members reach a certain age, because of the lack of board renewal. Therefore, we need to guarantee a strategic succession within the organization.
During the work of this General Assembly, the method and rigor have dominated. And to express their commitment and solidarity, the members of AFRIEN chose the executive secretary and all the members of their new board by consensus.
Merci à tous les amis.
I am grateful to the representatives of all the 23 West and Central African countries that have decided to elect me as an executive secretary of the West and Central African office of the organization. Our main objective today is how to implement AFRIEN in all the African countries, because this will provide us with more legitimacy in what we've been doing. We also want AFRIEN to be represented within other regions, provinces and communes. The other aspect is the follow-up regarding the ICDP 25, because we'll have to respect all the commitments that have been taken by our youth. People often say that youth are not that involved, but I think that since our mentor Nabi Gengoum arrived, we are more than ever in the front line, and we have to make profit of that position in order to deploy our awareness-raising campaigns within our countries first, and then regionally, before deploying throughout the whole continent. The Africa we want starts today, and this with us. We need to get involved from 14 to 35 years old in order to achieve this great project of the Africa we want through the ICDP 25. And I think that we have a courageous, dynamic and very committed youth that is aware of its potential. And with the support of our predecessors, we'll be able to arrive at something consistent.
Nous apportons un appui multiforme à AFRIAD, mais je pense que la partie la plus importante.
We have been providing some support of all types to AFRIEN, but I think the most important of all is to find out how to help AFRIEN become an important and credible institution that coordinates, facilitates and holds the voice of the African youth. So I think our support is multisectoral, and it's about accompanying, providing advice and coaching. We provide so many opportunities to AFRIEN, and the thing the most of which I am proud of is that now the African youth is present in all the places where great decisions about the continent are taken. We are a support for this association, which has been gaining ground for so long, and AFRIEN has now become a real proposition force.
Une véritable force de proposition.
The second edition of the 25 Heures de Dakar could then start with an assembly of united, ambitious and structured young people in presence of the mayor of Dakar and the regional director of UNFPA for West and Central Africa. In fact, the 25 Heures de Dakar has already taken on the dimension of an open forum whose function is to promote the meeting and collaboration between young people who throughout Africa are working to build the continent. Given the success of the 25 Heures de Dakar first edition and its contribution to the implementation of national and international development agendas, UNFPA and AFRIEN have decided to institutionalize the concept.
It's been an important thing to gather all the youths of the continent to decide on their own destiny, because as you know, they are future. When they say put young people first, that means we also need to put them in the front line and hear their voices. In my side, I'll keep the advocacy to the authorities so that the youths will be put in the front line to allow their preoccupations to be considered. This event needs to be perpetrated, and it's an honor for the city of Dakar to receive youths from all the sub-region. It's an exceptional event, even though I was not present in the 2019 edition. But I think we'll work with the department in charge of youths so that we'll prepare it and involve the maximum of Dakar people in this event.
Événement et impliquer le maximum de Dakarois dans cet événement.
UNFPA, bureau pays du Sénégal.
The UNFPA Bureau of Senegal worked on allowing the country to have a national strategy on the youth. Not only in Senegal, but in all the countries of the world, the UNFPA has a youth strategy that the organization wants them to adopt. In so doing, we help in all these countries so that they implement their youth strategy. In our office, we have some staff in charge of youth programs. That staff accompanies our partners in all programs involving the youth for concrete action. We have within our office three implementing partners, including the Ministry of Youth, represented by the PPJ. There's also the GEP and the CEFOREP that is in charge of the youth. In all our annual programs, we have some youth projects in 10 of the 14 regions of the country. The focus is put on three transformation results that are zero avoidable maternal mortality, zero gender-based violence as girls are the most victims of GBV, and zero unmet needs. Of course, youth need to avoid early marriages and early pregnancies. The UNFPA is doing its best for youth to reach their autonomy and independence so that their families as well as their countries could rely on them as productive youth within their own society.
The first panel, which dealt with the challenges of the demographic dividend for youth and for African cities by 2030, aimed to draw lessons from successful interventions and actions that have helped other countries or regions to exploit the demographic dividend and to consider their applicability in Africa. It highlighted successful experiences of countries that have achieved or are making encouraging progress towards achieving the demographic dividend in relation to the issue of urbanization and share the good practices in terms of approaches.
Depuis quelques années, nous parlons du concept dividende démographique.
We've been speaking about the demographic dividend for a few years now, but since 2018, the Office of the UNFPA, through its regional bureau and other partners, have started initiatives through that concept, thanks to the FAST project. In his speech, Mr. Mabigengom said that if we take profit from that demographic dividend opportunity, Africa might benefit from $500 billion in 30 years, if we follow the Asian model. We think that all the countries should respect the commitment they have made in international conferences so that we arrive at the Africa we want. Also, countries should deploy their roadmaps concerning their head of state's engagement to support youth by investing on their education, employment, and competence development.
Dans leur santé, dans leur emploi et leur développement de compétences.
Panel 2 focused on monitoring the implementation of youth commitments to ICPD, progress, challenges, and prospects. The purpose was to provide a space for youth to discuss progress in implementing the commitments they made in Nairobi to the ICPD agenda, looking at challenges, achievements, and opportunities. In a constructive and action-oriented dialogue, the panel took stock of existing initiatives and explored good practices and success stories.
The commitments that have been taken in favor of youth during that international conference are an opportunity for the Mauritanian youth to start constructing through direct recommendations that consist of focusing on employability and professional integration. Through these recommendations, we have seen that through the Ministry of Vocational Training and Employment, efforts are being made in favor of youth employment. Through AFRIEM, we made some awareness-raising campaigns for these commitments to be respected and implemented for the Mauritanian youth to fully take profit from it.
In the final communique of the second edition of the 25 Heures de Dakar, the youth of AFRIEM congratulated themselves for having participated in the International Conference on Population and Development in Nairobi and said they have made commitments to actively contribute to the implementation of the recommendations of this meeting. They deplored the fact that the COVID-19 pandemic had disrupted their traditional ways of working. They reaffirmed AFRIEM's role in the response through its country representations and said they will remain in the line of defense to completely eradicate the pandemic. Alongside this commitment, AFRIEM members noted that the challenges of building a better world where every person enjoys his or her rights and actively participate in development remain. The AFRIEM movement will continue its effort for the vulgarization of its slogan, Put Young People First, for the achievement of the demographic dividend within 2063 agenda, as well as reaching the Sustainable Development Goals. We are also aiming at raising awareness of all youths of the continent and elsewhere on the access to information related to sexual and reproductive health for youth and adolescents, on good governing, leadership, employment, and education. We also want to eradicate the use and consumption of narcotics at schools and university and for youth in general. As an extension of this 25 Heures de Dakar, a 90-minute section was organized within the framework of the Dakar Forum with UNFPA as a co-creator and during which the Fast Emergent Initiatives was honored. The idea was to promote current initiatives in the area of operationalizing the demographic dividend in relation to urbanization that have proven successful and could be scaled up. The section was organized around a panel including the African Development Bank, the mayor of the commune of Fès, a representative of the Dakar City Hall, and two young people from AFRIEM.
Rappeler que les 25 heures de Dakar sont organisées.
These 25 heures de Dakar have been organized to allow the African youth to get together each year in the Renaissance Monument to take an evaluation of the continent's evolution regarding the capturing of the demographic dividend. And as you know, it's a large and integrated agenda that includes sectors like education, health, training, employment, but also questions of good governance.
La formation, l'emploi, mais également les questions de gouvernance. Donc il était tout à fait normal en cette année où l'Union africaine.
That's why it's quite normal that this year the African Union focuses on art and culture, but also we are drawing near the end of the SDGs because we are at 9 years only before the end. We needed to work on going beyond what we have been traditionally doing. We need to go to a larger scale that will allow youth to bring additional contributions. To sum it up, it's a yearly event during which the African youth meet at the Renaissance Monument to evaluate the advancement level regarding the capturing of the demographic dividend and speak about the projects that are important for them.
Mais également parler de tous les autres chantiers qui leur sont chers.
The second edition of the 25 Heures de Dakar, in accordance with its ideals, was keen to reward actors of development in the youth. Members of AFRIAN were rewarded, as well as media organizations involved in the visibility and promotion of UNFPA programs and the Adolescent and Youth in Population and Development Network in West and Central Africa. It is all about giving priority to young people for the future of Africa, the Africa they want and that we want.